All right. We have found our place. Yellow post number 19. Out of 19. There were three or four others right in the beginning. Number four being one of them that were open. The rest are all taken except this one. This is at the very end. Not the end of the road, but the end of the single yellow post campsites. I like it. I'm far away from everybody. There's nobody else around here. So, it's a beautiful day. It's probably going to get a little chilly tonight, but I'm prepared for that. Dog likes it. I've already taken her for a quick little walk. She's going to have to just stay tied up until I set up camp. I'm going to set my tent up right over there. And amongst those bushes there. And there's the table. And the dog can just go crazy for a bit. Going around in circles. She wants to run around, poor thing. All right, let me get set up and then we'll run around. This is great. So I met with the guys, the rest of the ham radio operators up here. They're down there at Seven Oaks. They don't allow any dogs more than 20 pounds. And it's real close quarter camping with lots of people. So I prefer this kind of camping. In a little bit, when I get set up, we'll go to the end of the road and check out the cabin. There's Coon's Creek Cabin at the end of this road. Well, I guess it's not the end of the road, but it's down there a little bit more. So we'll go check that out in a little bit. Happy doggy. I got camp set up and I ran her around all over the place here. So she's happy and content for a bit. Got dinner cooking, or well, supper I guess you call it. Just some beans. I was going to make a sandwich but I forgot the bread. Can you believe that? So I'll pick some up later when I'm back down by the store meeting with the other guys. Let us have some beans. Good old cowboy food. Blazing Saddles. There's the tent. There's my view. Part of it. Can't have a fire. As far as I know, no campfires are allowed. Now they don't have these covered with pink tape like the last campground I stayed at. In fawnskin, but sign said no fires, so far as I know, no fires. It's okay. What a beautiful place I got here. Beautiful view. Got some beans in me. Then we're gonna go check out the Coons. Cabin, Coon's Creek Cabin. I believe out that way, or out that way, yeah, out that way somewhere. Somewhere down there that way is Coon's Creek Jump Off, or something Jump Off. And you should be able to see Palm Springs area down that way. I might be able to get into the 220 repeater from down there. I'll try it. I've got it programmed into the little radio. I'll see if I can make the, should be able to do it. Should be able to make the Southern California Edison system. Oh, yeah, nice. We got this whole valley, at least this end of it, to ourselves. Right there where my blazer is would be a perfect place for a hammock. There's actually a couple of neat places around here for a hammock, but that would be perfect right there. I'll bring a hammock with me next time. There's another one right there. So you could put two separate hammocks up here, right in the campsite. Thank you. are at Coon's Creek Cabin. My campsite is not even a mile. It's about a half a mile back down the road there. It's not very far. I've only been on the dirt road going real slow for about 5 minutes, so it's real close. This is a group camp area. Has a trash can over there. Grills. Picnic benches, and it even has a restroom right over there. So, dang. That's the desert out there. I don't know, Palm Springs is somewhere down there. Maybe to the left, maybe to the right, I don't know. I don't see it directly out in front, but that's the desert. I'll have to look on a map when I get back. But, yeah, beautiful place. Could have a nice group camp here. There's a fire ring, tables. Lots of room. And a big old cabin with a fireplace inside. We'll take a look in just a minute. I gotta go get the dog. 1980. Way We Goes 4x4 Club. I guess they put the concrete in here and restored this cabin. Put the foundation in. Probably lifted it up off the ground and put concrete under it. What usually gets done with cabins like this. I don't think it was built on the concrete. I think they, who knows? Lots of graffiti carved into the place and written in names. A lot of this stuff to see is from 2014, so these people came up and wrote on everything. So come on, sweetie. Come on, let's go in here. Let's see what's going on. Oh yeah, look at this floor. Yeah, see, this thing was in the dirt at one time. And then what they did was they raised the cabin up on the outside around the bottom, because the bottom logs are always first to go. And I don't know when they put these fire bricks in here, but here they are. Yeah, Jess ran around and put his name everywhere. Oh, he was here in 2010 too. But yeah, lots of Jessica and Jess. Really spent a lot of time here carving up the place back in 08, 2010. What is everybody named Jess? Had to carve their name. So yeah, nice fireplace. I'd like to put plywood over this floor. There was a fireplace in here. You're unbelievable. The way you get hung up on things, it's just unbelievable. Come on. Come on, get in here. Hey, Sabrina, come on. If there was nothing else to get hung up on, you'd get hung up on yourself. So you could get in out of the snow and the rain, whatever, in here. Andy Climax, okay. Don't know why people have to mess up such a nice place, but looks like it's a disease, huh? Everybody's got to do it. Hoof pack, yeah, even horse riders graffiti. 210, 211, 212, 213, 214. Oh well. I don't get it, but people do it. Got another cabin here. The roof got a little tore up there. And another cabin there. So they're separate cabins, little ones. Come here, sweetie. Let's go up here. Hey. Okay, I'll follow you. Come here. Come here. Let's see what's in this one. Huh. This one's not rainproof. The other one has a steel roof on it. Corrugated steel. This one got nothing. Oh. Wonder when these were put here. That one's got corrugated steel roof. $21.99.
I believe 81.
Of course, no camping trip would be complete without internet.
Exactly, right?
Yeah. It's Kyle and Eric, his dad Eric.
Hattie, Hattie.
Mr. Runner.
All right, let's call that, let's name it something and put it as our appointment. Those are 80 classic. Love you. But the name of that download.
Here's Dave, AF6TN. Say hello, Dave.
Hello, Dave.
All righty. A little campsite here. These things are fantastic. God, I almost had a...
Kyle made those.
I mean,
have
seriously.
One. Eat them, because we're not taking it home.
I'll have another one, yeah. But that thing just... made me want to scream. Look at how bright it is in here. I'm in the tent. It's night. It's dark. There's the dog. It's going to get cold tonight, so I brought this for her just in case. She can push it off if she doesn't want it. But we're here. And I got the heater going, too, so it may not get too cold. I don't know what it's going to get down to. But I'm at 8,000 feet, and it's October... what? I don't know. 18th? Something like that. Saturday anyway, Saturday night. So I can hit the Big Bear repeater up here no problem, but from inside the tent with the little wet quarter wave whip, I don't activate the transmitter for some reason. But from my truck with this plugged into the mag mount with the quarter wave, this is actually an eighth wave, with the quarter wave on the truck plugged in, I do get the repeater just fine, so I don't know what's up with that. But anyway, there's my 10,000 milliamp battery pack, and it's powering the thing that lights this place, my sun jack. Look at that. God, that's bright, isn't it? So, yeah, it really lights the inside of the tent up, and it really lights the outside up, too. If I hang it in a tree, it lights up the whole campground, so... Anyway, when it went down and had dinner with my friends down there at the Seven Oaks campground, I can't stay there because she's 60 pounds too heavy. They have a 20-pound weight limit on dogs. And rightly so. I understand why that is. It's because of irresponsible dog owners who don't know how to control their dogs and keep them on leashes. So they have to go with little yappy dogs is all they'll allow. So... stupid old me. I brought the computer in case I wanted to watch a movie, and now I don't really feel like it. I just want to go to sleep. So, there it is. That's the old XP computer, so it doesn't matter if anything happens to it. But yeah, we're in here, and we're getting ready to just turn the light out and go to sleep. So, I'll put my hat on, and I'll say goodnight to you. Oops. Yeah, that light is something else. So this is what I look like in here, and there's the dog. So yeah, we're all fat and happy. Had a pretty good day. Tomorrow, I don't know what's going to happen yet until I wake up, have some coffee, and I'll get on the radio and call Eric. See if they want to go to breakfast down there at the Argus Oaks or something. And if they do, that's what we'll do. And if not, we'll do some more exploring. Whatever. Should be fun. So, going to say goodnight. I can't think of any stories I want to tell right now. I usually have one, but not tonight. Oh, I did find out I can have a campfire because there's a ranger camped out right down the road here. And he had a campfire, and I stopped and I said, I didn't know he was a ranger at the time. I says, hey, what's up with the campfire? And he goes, well, I'm a ranger. I go, well, so what? He goes, well, you can have a campfire too. I said, I can, because I called the Forest Service Center, the Discovery Center in Big Bear, and they said, no, Yellow Post is still under fire restrictions. So she said you couldn't do it. And I saw him with a campfire, and I saw some other people with a campfire, but I didn't want to approach them because they were down another road. I didn't want to go down there. So when I saw the second one, I went ahead and stopped and I yelled at him. I asked, you know, nicely. And he turned out to be a ranger. And he says, yeah, I'm a ranger. And, you know, as long as it's not out of control, go ahead. And I go, well, great. Now you tell me. I don't have any firewood. And I'm not going to go out in the dark and collect it. So we just decided to go to bed. Maybe tomorrow night, if we stay. Maybe tomorrow night. We'll see. So with that, Mobile Tech saying good night. And Sabrina says good night. Woohoo!